Saturday, you guys. Hope you guys have a fantastic morning and or day whenever you see this. We are going to celebrate a little happy birthday Pam today. So Pam, hopefully you're having a fantastic day. I should say Pam McDonald, all right? Because we do have a couple Pams in our community, but Pam McDonald, happy birthday. Hopefully you're having a fantastic, fantastic start to your weekend, all right? Before we get to the workout, we're going to play around with a little bit of gymnastic strength today. But before we get to the actual work set, we'll take you through the work set, or our warm-up, sorry. Myself and Tyler are going to take you through a body wake-up. So just a quick head to toe. We're going to spend most of our time on our wrists today. So just to wake them up for our handstands and kind of all the planking that's going to take place in the warm-up. All right. Then what's going to happen is we'll take you through this piece right here. Inchworm walkout. So you're going to walk yourself out into that extended plank, 3 to 5 reps. Again, there's no time frame in terms of the hold. I just want you to think about holding for control. All right, so just show control of the movement, good body control, then walk it back in. From there, we'll move into some plank leans. All right, it's a great exercise to work on those shoulders and work on that core work, a little bit of wrist mobility. So again, 10 to 20 reps alternating back and forth. Any time frame, any little pause, if you'd like to add that in there, please be my guest. Into our laying down position. So we're gonna work our floor facing angel. So that's the floor facing angel with extension today. So we're gonna work on just working on that extension through the arm, getting those triceps kicked on and feeling those things kind of say hi. Anywhere from 5 to 10 reps here. It doesn't have to be fast, it doesn't have to be slow, but again, showing control and kind of ownership over the movement, all right? Finishing off our work set with a PVC prone raise, I'm gonna show you a couple variations with a broomstick, PVC, empty hand, depending on what you have around the house right now. But you're gonna do 3 reps, 10 second holds each. Very similar to our body tightener. So if you would like to sub the body tightener in to this as well, you're more than welcome to, okay? 3 rounds of that. We'll then move into a little bit of isometric holding work with the dumbbell and or kettlebell into an overhead hold, all right, for 20 seconds, into a front rack hold for 30 seconds, and then a single arm farmer's hold for 20 seconds. Then you repeat on the opposite side, taking it from the overhead all the way through. And then you're gonna work on your handstand of choice for 10 to 20 seconds. All right, just to kind of get you squared away, get yourself ready, your core heated up for what's to come. And you're gonna hit that anywhere from 3 to 5 rounds. All right? The work set, you guys, is 3 rounds, not for time, but 3 rounds of a handstand hold of 30 to 60 seconds. Any kind of handstand hold, and we'll walk you through a couple options for you guys. We practiced them in yesterday's warm-up though, so any variation or what you did yesterday is a good option as well for today. Then you're gonna move into our hollow hold on the floor for 30 to 45 seconds, and then your arch hold on your stomach for 20 to 30 seconds. And then rest a bit, or go right back into it and take those 3 rounds down for quality, all right? At the end of our day together, you are gonna take down 2 to 3 rounds of this little piece right here, laying tuck and tilt, 3 to 5 reps, bridge hold for 20 to 30 seconds, butterfly bridge hold for 10 to 20, and a dead bug holding of 10 seconds per side. All right, we'll take that through, and that's just gonna open up the hips and get the body ready to go. But for now, let's warm you guys up, and we'll get you ready, all right? All right, guys, let's get ourselves warmed up. We'll get our feet underneath of our hips. We'll take our arms big and tall up overhead. We're just gonna reach to one side, big long stretch. Then we'll come back through, reach to the other side. Then we'll come back up. And from here again, we're gonna lose our neck and then find our neck and then lose our neck and find our neck. And one more time, lose our neck and find our neck. We'll get some gentle little circles around the arms. Nice and easy. Try and keep these kind of initiated through the shoulders. All right, we're gonna take that down to the mid-T position. All right, those scapula doing the work. And then we'll take it down a little bit more, down to that low T position, palms forward. And then we're gonna change directions. So we're gonna change directions, get that nice low T position, we'll move it up into that mid-T position. And then from there, all the way up overhead. And then from here, we're gonna clasp our fingers, press way up, reach to the side, reach to the side, come back through center, round out that upper back, press, press, press those arms forward, big stretch again, reach, and reach. Then we're gonna release those fingers and forward fold all the way down to the floor, touch those toes, rock up the shins. We're gonna come down, plant both hands and step back with both feet into our plank. From here, we're gonna tuck the pelvis and press into those shoulders, holding for 3, 2, and then we'll press back into our down dog, soft knees, then we'll come back into our table. So our hands are under our shoulders, knees into those hips, and we're just gonna move through a nice little scap push-up. So arms stay straight, we'll pull the shoulders together, we'll press up, we'll pull the shoulders together, press up, and pull the shoulders together, and press up, and then take some gentle circles around those hands. Again, nice and gentle as we wake up those hands, those wrists a little bit. Depending on what time you're doing this, these hands might not have had a chance to do anything today. We'll go the other way. So we just wanna make sure we're easing into those hands and wrists a bit. Nice and gentle. From here, we're gonna come back to center and do one cat-cow. So we'll tilt and reach, lift the chest, and roll the pelvis and round out. Neutral table. We're gonna turn the fingers to the outside. And we're gonna do some leans. So we're gonna press into the shoulders a bit and just shift to one side, pressing into the fingers, and then shift to the other side, press into those fingers, and again shift, and shift over, and shift one more time, and over. And we'll come back to center, turn the fingers to the inside, press into those arms. We're gonna lean to one side, lean to the other, nice and slow, lean to one, lean to the other, and then one more time, we'll lean, and then we'll lean. We'll come back to center, we'll turn the fingers to the front, and we're gonna get one more cat-cow. So we'll tilt the pelvis, lift up, and roll up. Neutral table. From here, we're gonna sit back into our heels. We're gonna keep our chest up nice and high, and arms are straight. We're gonna pull the hands back, and then we're gonna lower down. And we're gonna pull the hands back and lower down and pull back and lower down. Come back into your table. We're gonna lift the thumbs, come up onto that first knuckle as best you can, and lower down. Lift up and lower down. And lift up and lower down. We're gonna sit back into our heels again. One more time, chest up, arms straight, pull the hands back and lower, pull back. And lower, and pull back, and lower. From here, we're gonna tuck those toes under, extend up into our down dog, come back into our plank, tuck and press, tiptoe those feet all the way up. We're gonna roll ourselves up, big stretch, clasp those fingers again, press way up to the ceiling and reach, and reach. Good, come back up, bring those hands down. And if you'd like to continue warming up the body a little bit, spending some more time in the shoulders, the hips, depending on how they're feeling, please do so. We're gonna move into our next phase of work here, into our warm-up. So what we're gonna get Tyler to do is stay kind of facing this direction right now. We're gonna go through our inchworm walkout. So we have 3 to 5 reps, we're gonna get him to do 3. So he's gonna take his body down to his toes, and he's gonna walk himself out with good control, and he's gonna take his hands anywhere past his normal plank position. He's gonna really work on tucking the pelvis and pressing through those lats and then walk himself back in. So remember with these, we wanna make sure we're going out past our plank but only going as far as you can come back with. So he's gonna move into his next rep. He's just gonna walk out. And again, as you move through these movements, you might find that you can get a little further out each rep, all right? Or not, and that's okay. So Tyler's doing a good job at really focusing on those lats, that pelvis in that good hollow position. We'll get him to do one more rep as he walks himself out with good control, staying nice and tight, finding that hollow, and then walking himself back into his plank. Right? Again, depending on the floor surface you're using, please pay attention to that so you're not sliding out onto the floor, because we want you to make sure that the face looks just the same as we started. Okay? Nice and tight. From there, we're gonna go back into our plank so he can walk himself out into his normal plank. We've been doing these plank leans quite a bit because they're a great exercise in building core strength and shoulder mobility. So he's gonna press up into his shoulders so he gets that nice rounded position. He's gonna lean over to one side and then shift back to the other side. He's just gonna take 10 reps at his own pace. So again, with these, we're working on maintaining that nice tucked pelvis, that good pressure through the shoulders, and focusing on that good upper back, making sure those shoulders are pressing towards the ceiling to make sure we're stabilizing those shoulders. Once he's done his last rep, we're gonna move down to the floor. So he can just take it down onto a laying position. He's gonna get to the bottom position of his push-up. His toes are gonna come together. He's gonna press them into the floor. He's gonna tuck his pelvis, and he's gonna squeeze his hands off the floor, and he's gonna press them back towards his feet and lift to the ceiling, and then come back into that push-up position. And then he's gonna do it again. So he's gonna lift them up and press them back so he gets his tricep kicked on, and then come back in. He'll reset his position if he has to. How about we knock off three more reps, just kind of nice and steady. So he feels that engagement through his triceps, comes back in, and then resets and takes his next rep. All the while, those toes are into the ground. Tops of the feet can also be into the floor as well, but we're not lifting those feet like we do in an arch up, and we're not lifting the torso either. It's staying pretty level to the floor. Nicely done. Those are very, very gentle. From there, we have our PVC prone raise. I'm gonna show you three different variations. So we have a PVC. If you have a broomstick, you can work with that as well. All right, we also have a towel, which we'll get in there as well. But for now, he's gonna go back onto his stomach, same position like he was gonna do his floor-facing angel. He's gonna set his hollow. His head is gonna stay in that same position, and he's gonna lift that PVC straight up and hold for 10 seconds. Not gonna make him hold for 10 seconds exactly, but he's doing a good job of keeping that head down, torso neutral, and then he's gonna roll back down. Something that can be really tricky sometimes is if we pull the knuckles up, it kind of tricks us. I want you to think more knuckles straight ahead to keep it so we're focusing on lifting through the arm and shoulder and not just lifting through the knuckles. So Tyler, we'll just show that one. He gets set to do it. He's gonna pull his knuckles back and it tricks him. Put this back this way, yep. It tricks him in terms of thinking about how high he's getting when really we want those knuckles pointing straight ahead, right? And relax. If you don't have a PVC or a broomstick handy, if you have a tea towel, all right, we can take hold of the tea towel at any kind of width that he needs for his shoulders. Again, he's gonna set the same position up in his hollow, his shoulder, his head position, and then he's just gonna squeeze and rip the PVC or the tea towel and lift up. Okay, so we don't want to rip it right apart, but we just want to get a little bit of tension on that tea towel, and that'll help engage that body, and he can relax that. From here, if you're like, I got nothing close by, he's going to pretend like he's holding onto a PVC pipe, so arms are straight out in front, and he's just going to lift those arms up to that position, maintaining that same torso position, same hollow, and he's still working just as much, he just doesn't have anything to hold. Okay, so super nice job. From there, just as a quick recap, all right, we have three rounds to take that down. We're gonna move on to our next phase, but we have inchworm walkout for 3 to 5 reps, into a plank lean, 10 to 20 back and forth, into a floor-facing angel with that extension, and then our PVC prone raise or our prone raise of some sort. Okay, so lots of options there for you guys. Three rounds of that, and then we're gonna move into this next phase. So this next phase, you're gonna have one round we'll use a kettlebell, and we're gonna face the front, or sorry, face this way, and then we'll do the next round on the other side with a dumbbell, and we'll face the camera. So his first wave of movements, he's gonna clean the kettlebell up, or he's gonna snatch it overhead to get into that overhead position, and he's gonna hold it there for 30 seconds, all right? Sorry, 20 seconds, not quite 30. We're not gonna make him hold the whole thing, but a couple things to look at as he's holding is that kettlebell's in good position, his wrist, elbow, and shoulder are all in good, squeezing his ribs in, and he's squeezing his glutes, and his 20 seconds are up, he's gonna lower that kettlebell down to his front rack position. So the kettlebell front rack is a little different than a dumbbell, it's gonna rest on the arm a bit, but again, his torso, his midsection hasn't changed, all right? This next phase of work is gonna be for 30 seconds. And then he's gonna lower the kettlebell down to the side into our farmer's hold. He's gonna really work on not twisting or rotating to the side, staying super square. Again, ribs, glutes, don't move at all, okay? Once he's done that all the way down to his farmer's carry, he's gonna put that down. For now, you guys can switch sides. We're gonna switch apparatus so you can see from the front. He's gonna do the other side for you with the dumbbell. He's gonna snatch it overhead or press it overhead. Again, working on that good line of action, ribs in, like I was gonna hit him in the stomach. I'm not going to, but we wanna make sure that he's nice and tight, holding in that good overhead position. From there, he's gonna lower the dumbbell down to his shoulder, to his front rack. Preferably keeping that dumbbell on a 45, so we have to work on engaging through that side body, through the lat, so we're not just tipping it up, all right, straight up and down, we're really working on maintaining a good midline here. And then from there, once he's done his 30 seconds, he'll pull the dumbbell down over the side, again, making sure he's staying square through the shoulders and not tipping to the side. We're really focusing on that square tight body position, all right? Once he's done his 20 second hold there, he'll put the dumbbell down, and then he will move on to his handstand practice. All right, so his handstand practice today, we're just gonna go over those movements again for you guys that we have for the different handstand options like we did yesterday. So if you're doing a wall handstand, awesome. Kick up, walk up, whatever you gotta do. Tyler's gonna walk himself into his box or his couch handstand, and he's gonna get into that nice set position, and we're gonna go from here in that good handstand. From here, we're gonna walk himself out again. He's gonna kick down, we're gonna slide these two little pads in there. And what I'm gonna do is move that in a little bit for him too, so you can see a little bit fresher. And he's gonna put his knees up on that lovely, lovely box. In this box handstand, he's gonna kind of pull his heels to his glutes, and he's gonna walk himself in. So again, his hips, shoulders, and hands are nice and stacked, and he's constantly pressing into the floor with those arms, getting those shoulders up by his ears. From here, he can walk himself out again. He's just gonna kick down so I can move the pads out of the way. And he's gonna go into a elevated plank. So again, same rules apply. Pelvis is tucked, pressing up through his shoulders over his hand, and he's kind of looking in between his fingers or slightly forward to keep his head neutral, all right? From here, he can come down to the floor, and he can work through the plank. Right, so all of those different variations for your handstand, all right, can be practiced and used in this work set. So wherever you're at, please do so. All right, we'll give you a chance to break there for a second. All right, and then we'll do that again. So as a recap, we have 3 to 5 rounds of this. Dumbbell, kettlebell, overhead hold for 20 seconds, into a front rack on the same side for 30 seconds, and then a farmer's hold for 20 seconds. You'll switch sides, do it again, and then practice your handstand that you're gonna use in the work set, okay? In the workout today, Tyler is gonna work on his wall handstand, so we're gonna get the box out of the way, but if you would like to continue warming up, pause the video, move through that work set 3 to 5 times. It's a great strength piece, so please just don't gloss over and be like, I'm just gonna get to the work set. This is part of the workout right here. This is a great chance to work on multiple positions of stability for the shoulder and for the midsection, all right? So take advantage of it anywhere from 3 to 5 rounds, okay? So if you'd like to pause, pause. If you'd like to replay some of those coaching cues, please replay them and get the most out of those cues, all right? The movements in our work set. We just went through the handstand. So same handstand that you're practicing here, we're gonna use in our workout. The hollow hold, I'll get him to lay in the middle here on his back, feet pointing that way, hands this way. Again, with the hollows, we use these quite a bit. He's gonna relax for a second, and now what I want him to do is he's gonna squeeze his toes, reach his arms, and press down, so there's no space between the low back and on the floor. Now we'll relax, and now we'll do a single leg hollow, so both hands will come up, one leg will come while the other one stays down, okay? And relax. If that's still a little too challenging, what he's gonna do is he's gonna pull a foot flat up on the floor, one leg nice and extended, and then pressing down. This just gives you a little bit more kind of foundation for that pressure down, all right? Now, the next phase of these hollows, if you're like, still can't get that low back down, his hands are gonna come down the side of his body like a front lever. So you can do the double, you can do the single, and you can do that bent leg variation as well, all the same. Right? It's just a little easier with the hands down the side. You can generate a lot of pressure through the core. It's just not gonna be as challenging to maintain that low back position. Okay, super good hollows there. The next phase again is the arch hold in the work set. So he's gonna roll onto his stomach. So in this work set, he can do very similar work sets. 2 feet as he reaches those feet together, reaches those arms, toes squeezing together nice and tight like you're squeezing a nice little towel in between. He can do lower down, and then he can do single arm, single leg, and he can work on that alternate. If you're gonna do this variation, just split the hold up. So we have 20 to 30 seconds, just half per side. Make sure that you get an equal amount on per side of the body. Okay? But we're working on holds today, so we're not doing it too dynamic. So we just wanna make sure we're holding and then holding. Okay? So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna put Tyler through one round of this work set and then go through that next phase. So what I'm gonna get him to do is get ready to kick up into his handstand. I'll keep time for him. We're just gonna give him a chance to play with some of these so you can see them. And if you'd like to join, you are more than welcome, all right? But if you'd like to, again, practice a few more things. If you're still warming up, get yourself ready, get yourself comfortable, and we'll get you going, all right? From here, what he's gonna do, he's gonna start his handstand by kicking up into that nice handstand or walking into. He's gonna work on that nice line of action. So again, pressing through the floor, staying super, super tight through the midsection. Toes are squeezed together. Regardless of what variation you're doing in this handstand, we want to make sure that we're actively pressing through those shoulders. He's got about 15 more seconds to go in this 30-second hold, so he's going to stay nice and tight, focusing on his breath as he maintains that tension. Okay? Nice, solid position. That's his 30 seconds, so you can kick on down. He's going to flow onto the floor here. He's going to move right into his hollow. Again, you guys, you can rest as much as you need to in between these exercises. You can rest and break these down as you need to. He's doing really good at just flowing right to the next exercise, but we want to make sure we're maintaining position the entire time, which he's doing really well, and he's breathing through. So he's got another 30 seconds to go, or sorry, 15 seconds to go. Not quite 30 seconds, all right? But he's just gonna work on focusing on pressing his low back down. Like I was gonna step on his stomach, I wouldn't do that. But we wanna make sure that he's pressing down super tight, and now he can relax and roll over onto his stomach into his last hold of the work set, which is gonna be a 20 second arch. So he just tucked his toes together there. He's working on reaching long. Right, toe together action is what we're after at the back because it's going to help stabilize and close the chain of the lower body. Okay, he's got 5 more seconds in that 20 second hold. He's doing super well here, holding strong, and relax. So what Tyler would do, he's done one round, so if he really wanted to just jump right back into his handstand, he could. If you wanted to rest about 30 seconds to a minute, you can do that as well. Give yourself what you need to make sure that these three movements right here are done for quality for every second you bank. All right? So 3 rounds, handstand hold, 30 seconds to 60 seconds, hollow hold, 30 to 45 seconds, and then an arch hold, 20 to 30 seconds. All right? So if you're plugging away at that, you can either pause the video and keep going for those other 2 rounds or 3 rounds, whatever you need to take down. We're going to go through this last piece that's going to help move Tyler's hips around a little bit and open those things up. So what Tyler's going to do for me, he's going to lay on his back, feet that way. Arms are going to be kind of chilled by the side for now. And what he's going to do is bring his feet up nice and flat like he's going to do a bridge. His hands are going to come down to the side, and he's going to work through his tuck and tilts. So he's going to press his low back down. He's going to take his arms up above to end range. So if he can get to the floor, awesome. If not, no worries. But he's gonna keep reaching, and now what he's gonna do is tuck his pelvis, lifting it hopefully off the ground, and then he's gonna lower and tilt it the other way. And then he's gonna tuck and squeeze. Good, and tilt. Good, so in the tilt, we'll get him to do 3 more reps on his own. In the tuck, you'll feel your core super, super tight. And on the tilt, you're gonna feel those abs turn off, all right? But again, I don't care if you get your hips off the floor. That's a byproduct of a really, really strong pelvic tilt or tuck, sorry. We wanna make sure that it's not the focus if we use our feet like a bridge. We wanna make sure it's the tucking of that rib and hip that's gonna get those hips off the ground, all right? We'll get him to do that finish off. And now from here, what we have is a bridge hold. So his hands can come down the side of his body. What he's gonna do is just squeeze his glutes, open up his pelvis, and he's gonna hold that for 20 seconds. Again, too, what you can play with is pressing down with the hands a bit if you'd like to support and have engage the chest and the upper back, and really working on that squeeze. While we're in this bridge, His knees are bent at a 90 like he's in a tabletop but upside down. His low back is going to be pressed against the floor the whole time, and then he's going to extend opposite sides as far as he feels comfortable, and he's going to hold that one side for 10 seconds, maintaining contact with the floor, and then he's going to come back together, and then he's going to do the other side, and he's going to hold that position for 10 seconds. So we're going to work some isometric holds here in this dead bug, opposed to just alternating reps back and forth. Really nice, we'll bring it back together, and then you can relax. And then you can do that again, anywhere from 2 to 3 rounds of work. It's a nice chance to open up the hips, balance out the body, still working the core, it's not getting the rest here, but it's not quite as intensive as say V-ups or those hollow ups, all right? But it's still gonna give you a chance to work on some strength, okay? So what we have for you guys, we have 2 to 3 rounds, laying tuck and tilt, 3 to 5 reps. Beautiful exercise to stretch out the lats and to work on that nice low back and pelvic region. Into our bridge hold, 20 to 30 seconds. Butterfly bridge, 10 to 20 seconds. And then one 10-second hold per side in the dead bug, 2 to 3 rounds. And that's a nice ease into your cool down. If you'd like to throw around anything else that you need for that cool down, please do so, all right? But again, thank you for joining us on this beautiful Saturday. Happy birthday, Pam McDonald. Enjoy your day. Have a fantastic day. And again, you guys are awesome. Let me know how those handstands, hollows, and arch ups go. And let me know what you did for your handstand. I'm looking forward to seeing pictures and or seeing some posts. But for now, big hand up, big hand up, big step, high five. Great job, you guys. Have a fantastic day.